Okay, you know, the other day, Scott from the Southern Delaware Tourism said, hey, can we have these folks from Bostar Coast on the air? And I said, absolutely. Then I started looking at this website. It's called BoastOurCoast.com.
Host?
Let me get it right. Host Our Coast. Don't boast. All right, because then it'll go somewhere else. You might not know. Host, H-O-S-T, Our Coast.com. HostOurCoast.com. It's a travel blog, and here we have Paul Cox and Melanie McLean here, and we're ready to talk to you. You guys, you applied for this job to be travel bloggers for this area. Where were you when that happened?
We found out about the job in Bariloche, Argentina, and we submitted our application while we were in Uruguay, actually. Montevideo.
What were you doing there? Travel blogging?
Travel blogging, yes. We had a blog before this one that we were doing as a hobby. We were traveling around South America for about 4 months, and we were just really capturing all our experiences, getting tips for other travelers that were coming our way, or just traveling in general in terms of budgeting and stuff like that.
How successful was that hobby blog?
Well, it was pretty successful at our standards. We got a good following. Mostly it was our friends, but we were getting followers from the country we were visiting. We had people from Argentina, Peru, some people from China, some people from Spain, so we were getting some good worldwide coverage on it. And it was really successful for us because it eventually landed us this job at HostOurCoast.com here in the Delmarva region.
Which is great, which is, you know, Scott from Southern Delaware Tourism was saying it's kind of a joint effort with some tourism groups here in the area to put this on. Melanie, let's talk with you. Tell us what you do on Host Our Coast. Tell our listeners.
I'm more the visual side of it, so I'm the photographer, videographer. I'm usually the one putting the videos together and doing the production afterwards.
And so what's a typical week like for you as a travel blogger here in the middle of summer on Delmarva?
Typical.
Traveling to special events or what?
Nothing's too typical. We're kind of heading to restaurants. We're heading to events. We were just at the Nanticoke River Fest floating in kayaks. Actually paddling upstream, trying to get video footage, and then paddling or floating down with some of the locals. And
as a matter of fact, I saw that on the blog. Paddle kayaking is the new scooter.
Yeah, I did. I was able to go paddleboarding, they call it, down the bay right behind our condominium in Ocean City, and it was a really cool event. And you pretty much stand on a surfboard and just paddle down, and that's kind of a typical thing, a non-typical event. So it's really cool.
And so you put video of that up or pictures or something, right?
Right. Yes, we try to get video and photos of everything we do. Photos at least, videos always.
Right. And how has it been going? HostOurCoast.com. Tell me how do you judge the success of this or how it's been going?
We obviously have the views at the bottom of the page of each article or piece, but we also have Google Analytics. When Paul and I go out to restaurants, even we're being noticed. So I guess that's a sign of some good responses.
Hey, look, it's the Host Our Coast people. You're all kind of celebrities because you're on, you'll see you guys enjoying the stuff.
Yeah, I mean, we love it. Success for us is really rated on how well we like the work, and we're loving the work here. So we're getting a lot of good feedback. We're getting a lot of hits to the sites. We're getting a lot of people coming in and be like, hey, you guys are the Host Our Coast, and you should come check out this. And on Facebook and on Twitter, we have really good involvement with people giving us recommendations, telling us stuff that we should go see, or stuff that we're doing right, or maybe some hints of what we should do better.
You know, it's powerful. The internet is so powerful. I'll tell you how I feel about it. I'm hosting the radio show today, and I check out your travel blog, and it's so well done, I thought, so well put together. I considered you both to be like celebrities that I was going to interview. And I really, like, really in the know. I mean, it's really well done.
Thanks a lot.
I was excited. I go, oh, wow, I get to interview these people today? How exciting.
We're definitely reaching out there on Facebook and Twitter as well. That's a big part of our following, and like Paul said, our relationship with people, and that's how we're getting involved in the community more and seeing what locals really feel is important to them in the area.
So how long is this going to last?
We have exactly 1 month left today, so it's supposed to go to the August 15th. We'd love to go more because it's such a great job. I mean, this is our dream, really. So even after Host Our Coast, we're going to continue to travel blog and continue to really explore the world.
Yeah, amazing. So get this. They get to travel. They get to hang in this area, experience the restaurants, the events, the people, the places, write about it on the internet, and that's your job. That is a dream job, and you do it well.
Thank you. I mean, it really is a dream job, so it's really easy to do well at it and have fun with it. So we're really excited. I mean, we don't consider ourselves celebrities, so we really appreciate you saying that. I mean, this is the first time that we've gotten that status, I guess, but we're just having a great time with it, and we really enjoy the people here. Everyone's been really forthcoming and real helpful with everything we've been doing and really supporting us.
I can just tell it's a great blog filled with information. I look at all the local blogs, you know, daily and some other blogs, and I said, wow, this one popped out of me as being something really extra special. HostOurCoast.com. Now, here's a store, Browseabout Books, filled with travel books. They have one of the best travel sections, you know, that you'll ever find. Is this the future of travel journalism, the blog?
I think yes. I mean, I think the future is here, sort of. We saw this one guy traveling up this difficult mountain in China, and he had the camera strapped to him doing the same sort of thing. And I think that's what it is. It's local, you know, people down to earth. Not down to earth, but people that are inspired by what they do, just grabbing a camera and going for it, and that's basically what we did.
What about the commercial? Now, you would hope to keep doing this. There's got to be a commercial aspect to it, or somehow you've got to make a living doing it. So, in this case, I guess you're paid by the local tourism folks to do it, and you're doing it well, I think. But what happens after that? Can it become a commercial enterprise?
I believe it can. I mean, we see some travel blogs in South America, infoblog.com, and he makes a decent living off it. He does some side freelance work as well. The hope is that we can live off this and just be able to travel and get paid to travel and get paid to write our experiences down and share them.
Because travel writers, traditionally, who have made their living out of travel writing, would be sent in different places for different people, kind of freelance. So is that how you see your current lifestyle right now?
Well, before this, I was a freelance photographer, so I'm kind of used to that realm and I'm ready for that. So, yeah, that's definitely what I intend to do, and I think Paul's right there with me.
Like somebody, I'll pick a place, you know, Costa Rica or something, wants to promote themselves through this platform, you might be the folks to do it, right, if they would hire you.
Correct, yeah, if they would hire us, then we would definitely be the first ones there on the beaches of Costa Rica in the jungle, really reporting on it. So, I mean, we've never turned down an experience. We don't have our feet planted. I don't see our feet being planted anytime soon. We love seeing the world. We love traveling around. So this is something that we want to do for a very long time.
Have you ever been here before you took the blogging job?
I have, yes. I'm actually from Maryland, from Fort Washington on the western side. So I used to come here in high school and hang out with friends.
How about you?
I was here when I was maybe 6 years old, so it's been a real long time. So it's cool to rediscover all this stuff, and I hear there's a lot more going on here than there was then. So it's really interesting to me. It's like traveling another country, except there's no language barriers.
Yeah. Look, I'm going to follow you guys on Twitter today when I get back to the office, and I can do that. Paul Cox and Melanie McLean, HostOurCoast.com.
Yes. HostOurCoast.com. Our Twitter account's at HostOurCoast. And there's a HostOurCoast fan page on Facebook if you want to check that out as well.
I hope our listeners do that because this is a really great blog. It's the kind of thing that you want to say, hey, you're visiting the area? Take a look at this. And that's what the tourism folks wanted. I think they've done a good job. Scott, how do you think it's been going? Let's get Scott on here real quick. I'm sorry, guys. This is how it works in the high-pressure world of radio. Scott, how's it work?
I think it's working really well. I think in the end, it's really, you know, visitors promoting to other visitors, and that's what we want. And they want to hear it from us. They want to get it from a visitor's perspective.
Got it. WGMD, Rehoboth Beach, Delaware.